Hello everyone, greetings from Munich, Germany, and in this video we continue talking about matchmaking, about our process, and I want to share with you some secrets to open to you some inner processes, how we actually conduct interviews with the leaders. For those of you who are new on this channel, I want to present myself formally. My name is Svetlana Mucha. I'm the founder, the dating coach, and the leading matchmaker at Diola.com. And since 2008, we introduced truly exceptional, romantic, and open-minded singles who believe that love knows no borders and no nationalities. And on this channel, we talk a lot about dating, building a relationship, building a healthy relationship, about flirt, about courtship. So let's jump into the topic. I know that in many videos I have already shared with you glimpses what we do during the interviews with the ladies, and usually men think that all they have to do is just show his picture. Usually men think that all they have to do during the interview with the lady is show a photo of our male client. And if we are talking about the interview with the lady for a particular client, not just the interview to join our database, then of course I would say that one of the first five question that the lady will ask is, can I see his photo? But we don't start the interview with showing the photo of our male client. To get there, we have to actually talk to a lady to determine whether it is necessary to show her the picture of this client, to suggest her to go out on a date with this gentleman. And sometimes we have to do some advertisement to make sure that she actually gets intrigued and more curious to go out with our client. We built really a strategy how to present our male client in the best way, in the best light, to make more desirable for the exact lady. During the interview, I like to ask a lady about relationships she would like to have. I like to ask her about qualities she is looking for in a man. And sometimes ladies give you some cliche, like, I want him to be able to take care of me. And then we dig deeper and we talk about what she really means. To take care of her financially, in a sense that he will provide for her, to take care of her emotionally, in a sense that he will spend with her lots of time, or that he will fix all the broken doors and all the broken furniture in her apartment. What exactly does she mean? Sometimes ladies start talking about romance. She romanticizes way too much relationship, men, love in general. So you can tell that she's a little bit juvenile when it comes to love, and I try to understand whether it will work well with my male client, or he needs someone more mature, someone more realistic, someone who doesn't see love through pink glasses. Also, I like talking about past experiences, because you can learn more about insecurities of the lady, about her background, about her fears, about her expectations. For example, a lady can tell me that she has been in this relationship for, let's say, 3 to 4 years, and then her boyfriend has decided that he was not ready for marriage, and now she wants to meet someone who is really marriage-minded. And of course, you can understand what type of a man will get her attention, and what type of questions and conversations will earn extra points and make this man more appealing in the eyes of this lady. During these interviews, I also try to see how open, how direct the lady is with me, whether she is talking using some cliche phrases, or she shares her own experiences, is she afraid to be vulnerable, what questions she is asking about my client or about the matchmaking process. Because when you get an interview with a lady and she starts asking you questions like, do you have someone really successful in your database? Because look at me, I'm very beautiful and I want to date someone very, very successful, someone really well off, because I want to marry up. This is one scenario. Or for example, when I get a lady and she likes learning foreign languages, she likes traveling, she's adventurous, she's curious, and she wants to date someone similar. She wants to have this romantic adventure that will lead to a relationship. She wants to mix cultures. So that's another scenario. For example, if you are working with a gentleman who represents another religion, let's say he is a Muslim, I try to understand how open a lady is to date a gentleman who represents another religion, how important it is to her. Sometimes we get ladies, for example, a Jewish lady, and she wants to date only someone Jewish. Then again, I want to learn more about her traditions, because different Jewish families, they can follow these traditions to different levels, and I want to understand her expectations. Of course, another very important question is about kids, whether she wants to have children, how soon she wants to have children, because some clients of mine, male clients, they want to have kids and family ASAP, like as soon as possible, because he is 37 and he wants to start a family till he is 40, and he believes that when he will be in his 40s, he won't have enough energy to spend as much time with kids as he would like to. So he really wants to meet someone who also wants to have kids soon. And when I start talking to a lady and she tells me that she is 32 and she has all the time and she wants to travel first, she wants to do this and that, she wants to finish with her PhD, and after that she wants to have children. Yes, she wants a relationship. She wants to get married, she wants to have the special partner who will be her own cheerleader, her supporter, who will be with her while she's finishing this PhD so that they can later on travel and settle somewhere, but she doesn't want to have kids within the next 2 to 3 years. Then again, I understand that she's not the right match for my client because he wants to have kids soon. Or for example, I'm talking to another lady and she starts talking about kids, about marriage, about playing house, because her sister just had her baby, and this lady with whom I'm having an interview, she loves spending time with her newborn nephew, and she really, really wants to meet someone and to start a family of her own. Another scenario. Or for example, I try to understand if the lady can be actually open to relocate, let's say, to United States or to UK or to Japan, to Australia, let's say from Czech Republic or from Germany. And I ask her questions about her family, their traditions, about her past experiences. If she has been relocating like every 3 to 5 years because of work and because she wanted to live in different countries, one scenario. If she has lived in this town for the last 15 years because all her cousins live there, her parents live there, well, then probably going to United States, leaving her really big family behind will be complicated for her. And of course, I ask direct questions and see the reaction. And if after talking to a lady, I see that our male client can be someone she can choose for all the right reasons, and she can actually do her best to impress him in a good way, to give the good first impression, because she can be really interested, then of course I will tell her more about my male client, and I will choose which information I will share with her first, which information I will save for later. I'm not lying to our female members, so if the gentleman has kids, I won't tell that he doesn't have any children. But perhaps I will start by describing how smart he is, about his education, about his working experience, about his hobbies, and then I will come to the topic of children, knowing that this lady will really appreciate having a smart and hardworking man by her side. So this is a long process, and we build a real strategy, and only after that we share a picture. This female client, she has been out on a date with our other male client, but for whatever reason it hasn't worked out, and the date didn't meet her expectations, or there was something he said, she said, or simply he didn't choose her back. And now we know even better what she's looking for, and then we call a lady and we tell that, Anna, finally we have the right man for you, and we start telling about our male client, and we answer your questions. So we know how to present our male client best to make sure that the lady is intrigued, she's curious, and she really wants to meet him. Of course, it is important that during the date, our male client doesn't actually disappoint, because we raise the bar, we present him in the best light, and now it is his turn to make sure that all this impression that we have already created in the head of the lady, that it is proven by reality, by a real man, that he is as kind, as sweet, as smart, as witty, as, for example, Chaparros, as we have told a lady. So it is always a teamwork, a client, a matchmaker, a psychologist, all the managers, and we are always team client. Guys, I hope it was helpful. If you have any questions regarding the matchmaking process, you can leave them in the comments below this video. You can also request the first free consultation with the matchmaker by emailing us at katerina@diola.com or by filling in the form at our website diola.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, to press like, and I will see you in the next one. Svetlana Mucha, with love, specially for Diola.com from Munich, Germany.